Today we will discuss how to find the shape of different molecule by using VSEPR. Now in previous video I already discussed up to that 4 electron pair, that shape of different molecule having 4 electron pair in the central atom. Today we will start with that 5 electron pair, if 5 electron pair present in the valence shell of central atom. First compound is PCl5. First one is PCl5. Now phosphorus 5 electron, 5 chlorine contribute 5 electron. So total 10 electron. 10 electron means 5 electron pair. Now number of ligand equal to number of bond pair. So here how many chlorine? 5 chlorine. So out of 5 electron pair, all are bond pair, 5 bond pair. So when 5 bond pair, shape is TBP, trigonal bipyramidal. So PCl5 shape TBP, trigonal bipyramidal. And its hybridization 5 electron pair is sp3d. Now remember that sp3d, that is unsymmetric hybridization, it is a mixture of sp2 and pd. Equatorial 3 bond are sp2 hybridized, and x, that axial 2 bond, that one pd hybridized. That's why that equatorial bond are stronger compared to that axial bond, because higher S character means that one stronger bond. Okay, so if it is asked why equatorial bond are stronger than axial bond, then you have to explain it by that hybridization. So remember sp3d, it is a unsymmetric hybridization. Now sf4, sulfur 6 electron, 4 fluorine contribute 4 electron. So total 10 electron. That means 5 electron pair. Now how many ligand? 4 ligand. So 4 bond pair, 1 lone pair, because number of ligand equal to number of bond pair. So in this case, out of 5 electron pair, 4 bond pair, 1 lone pair. Now 4 bond pair, 1 lone pair, shape is seesaw, because due to that repulsion of that lone pair, axial bond that bend. So 4 bent pair, 1 lone pair, shape is seesaw. ClF3, chlorine 7, 3 fluorine contribute 3, 10 electron, so 5 electron pair. Now 3 ligand, so 3 bond pair, 2 lone pair. So 3 bond pair, 2 lone pair, shape bent T shape. And remember one thing, remember for that TBP structure. Now in TBP structure, lone pair always occupy equatorial position. Now why? Now see, equatorial angle is 120 degree, but axial angle is 90 degree, and lone pair require more space. So in TBP structure, lone pair always occupy equatorial position. Remember that in TBP structure, lone pair occupy equatorial position. So 3 bond pair, 2 lone pair, that one is bent. XCF2, xenon 8, 2 fluorine 2, 10 electron, 5 electron pair, now 2 bond pair, 3 lone pair. Now 2 bond pair, 3 lone pair, shape linear, because all the equatorial position occupied by that lone pair and axial position fluorine. So shape is linear because lone pair is experimentally invisible. In X-ray, that lone pair are not visible. So XEF2, that shape is linear. So till now we discuss that all different type of molecule having that 5 electron pair, different bond pair, lone pair, that's why their shape that different, but all are that same hybridization because electron pair is same, 5 electron pair, all are sp3 dehybridized. Next we will discuss that 6 electron pair, that means sp3 d2 hybridization. In that case, what are the possible structure? SF6, first one SF6, sulfur 6, fluorine 6, 12 electron, 6 electron pair. Now here 6 ligand, so 6 bond pair. So 6 bond pair, shape is octahedral. Six bond pair, shape is octahedral. Now that one symmetric structure because see all angle same, all are 90 degree, all angle bond angle is 90 degree. Okay, so it is a symmetric structure. ClF5, chlorine 7, 5 fluorine 5, 12 electron, 6 electron pair. Now ligand 5, so 5 bond pair, 1 lone pair. Now 5 bond pair, 1 lone pair, say square pyramidal. Shape is square pyramidal. 5 bond pair, 1 lone pair, shape is square pyramidal. So xenon 8, fluorine 4, 12 electron, 6 electron pair. Now ligand 4, so 4 bond pair, 2 lone pair. So 4 bond pair, 2 lone pair, shape square planar. Now in this case, why that lone pair occupy that axial position? Because in this case key, all angle are same. In equatorial also 90 degree, axial also 90 degree. That's why for symmetry we put that lone pair in axial position instead of equatorial position. Now 7 plus 7, 14 electron, 7 electron pair and 7 bond pair. 7 bond pair. Pentagonal bipyramidal, shape is pentagonal bipyramidal. Shape is pentagonal bipyramidal. XCF6, very important compound. See, 8 plus 6. 14 electron, 7 electron pair. Now how many ligand? 6. So 6 bond pair, 1 lone pair. Now it has an interesting structure. See what happens here. Now in this case, all the 6 position of that octahedral structure occupied by fluorine, and that lone pair rotate around that XCF bond. It rotate around that XCF bond. It rotate. That means position of lone pair is not fixed. Position of lone pair is not fixed. That's why it is called distorted octahedral structure. Distorted octahedral structure. Now this compound very important, many times it that came in that competitive exam, XCF4. that XCF6, sorry, XCF6, structure of XCF6, distorted octahedral, because position of lone pair is not fixed. I3 minus. Now in this case, see, out of three iodine, one iodine act as a central atom, other two act as a ligand. So see, 7 plus 2 plus 1. Now that one for negative charge. How many negative charge? That much of electron you have to add. How many positive charge? That much of electron you have to remove. So see, 10 electron, 5 electron pair. Now 2 bond pair, 3 lone pair, because ligand is 2 iodine. So 2 bond pair, 3 lone pair. So shape C, linear shape. I3 minus, its shape is linear. Now it is a charge compound, so over that third bucket we have to write that charge. So linear structure. XCOF4. Now in this case, see, oxygen form double bond. That's why it will not contribute any electron to the valence shell of xenon. So that we have to remember, that is drawback of Hesper. If any atom form multiple bond with the central atom, you have to remember, otherwise you cannot apply that Hesper. If any atom form double bond, it does not contribute any electron towards the central atom. Okay. So how you can calculate that electron? Now xenon 8, 4 fluorine 4. So 12 electron. Oxygen will not contribute because it formed double bond. So 6 electron pair. Out of 6 electron pair, see, 5 bond pair, 1 lone pair. So 5 bond pair, 1 lone pair. So 5 bond pair, 1 lone pair, we already discussed that one, square pyramidal. 5 bond pair, 1 lone pair, shape is square pyramidal. So see, Hesper is one of the important topic, okay, for that NEET exam. So try to learn this properly. Shape of that molecule is very important, and for that you have to apply that Hesper theory.